Thank you. So let's pray. Father, in your mighty and blessed name, we want to thank you, Adonai, because it is you who had predestined this day, this moment, and this time. Father, now we thank you for this meeting that has been congregated for us to worship you at the feet of Jesus, always coming to find something, bread for our lives. So we pray that this bread that you're going to serve us today shall bring life to our bones, that we may be edified and enriched, so that our lives may forever be transformed. We thank you, God, for this atmosphere has been charged by the Spirit of the living God. And even as your word comes forth, I pray that those that are sick shall be healed. I pray that those that have been bound shall be released. And I pray that, Lord, your Shekinah glory shall forever reign in the hearts of men. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Shout a big amen unto the Lord.
Amen.
Awesome. What a wonderful day.
Siku njema sana leo.
I want to start by introducing the heading for this administration. And I thank God that we did not discuss with Mama. And I'm so grateful that I even heard when she was here, she was talking things I was going to say. So I thank God because we are in alignment. So the title of this word is laying the foundation. Laying the foundation. In the book of Daniel, chapter 11, verse 32.
Katika kitabu cha Danieli,
11:32. It says that those that do wickedly against the covenant. I use NKJV, please. If I can get the NKJV version, that would be great. Thank you so much. Those who do wickedly against the covenant, the Lord, he shall corrupt with flattery. But the people who know their God shall do, shall be strong, and carry out great exploits. That was the scripture reading for today. But why I began with that, I wanted to show you the type of women for the sake of this conference that are strong, and those that do great exploits. It is not just any person. And I want us to lay the foundations. I love what Mama was saying in the morning and saying that we need to go back as church and lay down the foundation, not forsaking our first love, and stop going to church because you want to just feel like you're going to church, but you're going to church because you want that insatiable desire to be filled. So in the book of Genesis, chapter 1 and verse 2, we see that there is that God created man in his own image. I want to tell you where it all began. That's why I've started from where you started. I want to start from where you started. And then when I'm going on, see where you stopped. Then pick it up from there. And now come to this woman who can do strong and mighty exploits for God. So in the beginning, God created man, and in his image and in his likeness, he made Adam first, we know. Then he made Adam with Eve inside. Then Eve came out. You know, is that true? Are we together? So when that happened, God created man, a man that was incorruptible. But then again, something happened. Something happened that introduced the economy of sin into the livelihood of men. And that is what we are suffering until today. That sin was introduced, injected into our system. So now God said, because I and sin cannot stay together, I tell sin to go. So we were told, go.
Sasa tukambiwa tuende.
We went.
Tukatoka basi.
Immediately after that,
basi tukabada ile,
we were cast out.
Tukatomwa inje.
And we came to this earth.
Tukakuja pa duniani.
That you found us existing as earth.
Ambapo mlipata ni.
How many are on earth?
Je, watu wangapi
wako kwa hii dunia? Some of us are not on earth.
Wengine wetu hatuko hapa
duniani. Maybe some of us live in Jupiter.
Wengine wetu tunakaa
Jupiter. But I want us to understand. understand today.
Nataka leo tuelewe.
Mama has given me permission.
Mama amenipa ruhusa.
If I step on your toes.
Nikikunyakanyaga
toes.
It's not me.
The Holy Spirit.
Ni Roho Mtakatifu.
I blame it on the Holy Spirit.
Hey, na laumu Roho Mtakatifu.
So get ready to be trampled on.
Basi kwa tayari
get ready
kukanyaku.
To hear the truth.
Kuwa tayari kusikia
ukweli. We are not here to make you feel good.
Hatuko hapa kukufanya.
At the end of the day, your soul is more important to me.
Basi nafsi yako ni
muhimu. Than your presence being here.
Kuhusu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we were cast out.
Basi tulifukuzwa nje.
Then what happened immediately after?
Basi baadaye nini kilitendeka?
The economy of murder.
Uchumi basi.
Was introduced into mankind.
Ikaletwa basi kwa wanadamu.
Why did Cain kill his brother?
Mbona basi Cain alimuua ndugu yake?
Why did he kill his brother?
Mbona alimuua ndugu yake?
Do you know that sin?
Je, unajua kwamba dhambi
manifests many things.
Huwa inaonyesha mambo mengi.
I'm sorry. I will try. Many things.
Huwa inaonyesha mambo mengi.
Out of sin. That's why when we were singing here and saying out of our belly, it was not the belly of sin. It was the Spirit of God. Because out of us can come nothing good unless the Spirit of God enriches you and enables you, then out of you shall flow rivers. So now what did Cain do? Didn't he kill his brother? The economy of murder was introduced. But for me, I see it in another way. When I look at this, I said, Abel was giving sacrifices unto God that were pleasing unto God. But Cain was giving sacrifices that were not pleasing. This is the economy, the rise of two kingdoms, the kingdom of sin and the kingdom of God. And those that glorify God, those that live according to his statutes, are the ones that shall do great exploits. So we see this thing being introduced. And now I want to draw us where we are coming. Oh, I hope I am. I don't even know where my notes are. I am. They have gone and gone and gone and gone. Alabiala brosa takata. Oh, Rebecca diala besa takata. I wrote in my notes that darkness and light cannot mix. This one I'm giving as a disclaimer to anyone who is asking God, God, please bless this person. He's not born again, but I want to hold on to him. I want to tell you, because God likes sin, he separated us, because light and darkness cannot mix. So why are you asking God to bless what he has cast? What are you asking God to give you a spouse that he has not blessed you with? If that man is not of God, don't engage.
Hallelujah.
If you have a boyfriend, let me just do it nicely. Yomuelewe, wacha nisiende hivi. If you have a relationship or anything that you're engaging in that does not align to the light of God, you need to disarrange yourself, disengage immediately. Stop asking God for questions and the answer is already in the book. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, I told you I'll step on your toes. I'm sorry.
Poleni sana.
I'm sorry.
Poleni.
But this sin, the introduction of sin, was something so bad to us human beings. There was a time I was reflecting on this word, and I said, God, why? Because me, I love you so much. I wish I knew you before. I wish I was able to understand who I am before.
But
you know that's why Satan is so cunning. Because I asked myself a question, Mama. I said, indeed, if it was only Adam and Eve, how come this sin did not die with them? What was introduced in mankind that every man from that day had to carry sin? Every man had to carry sin in them. But we thank God.
Lakini tunashukuru Mungu.
Because Jesus.
Sababu Yesu.
This man Jesus.
Huyu binadamu Yesu.
What he did for you.
Kile ambacho alikufanyia.
If you do not understand, today you will understand.
Leo utapata kuelewa.
Today by the mercies of God.
Kwa huruma za Mwenyezi
Mungu. You will stop looking at yourself.
Utaanza kujiangalia.
And thinking I am so beautiful.
Na ukaanza kusema
ati mimi I have intellect.
Aha.
Ati mimi I have this.
Hey.
There is nothing you have.
Hakuna chochote
that you are not given.
Ambayo hukupewa.
There is nothing you have.
Hakuna chochote uko
nayo. That he did not give you.
Ambayo hakupewa.
So you better use it for the glory of God. If you think you're beautiful, use it for the glory of God. If you think you have something, use it for the glory of God. Come to the church, wash the church, take care of the house of God, use your gift for the house of God. Stop
Acha kusema wewe ni mrembo sana.
They die.
Walikufa.
Oh, don't we know? Have you ever looked at a dead body?
Umeshaiona mtu amekufa.
Have you ever seen a dead body?
Umeshaiona mtu amekufa.
Does it even look like what you look when you are alive?
Kama yule mtu ako mzima.
So we cannot boast children of God.
Hatuwezi basi jigamba wana wa Mungu.
Let's go back to my notes.
Acha turudi basi kwa somo letu.
Thank you Jesus.
Asante Yesu.
Awesome. So we find ourselves in a cycle.
Basi tunajipata katika mzunguko.
And a system.
Basi mkakati.
That has operated for many years.
Ambayo imekuwa kwa miaka mingi.
When we were born.
Wakati tulipozaliwa.
We found ourselves here.
Tulijipata ndani hapa.
But you did not understand.
Lakini hatukuelewa.
At that time.
Kwa wakati ule.
That there was a war concerning your life.
Kama kulikuwa basi vita
dhidi ya maisha. That is why when we come.
Kwa maana tunapozaliwa.
Some of us find ourselves in the clubs.
Wengine wetu tunajipata kwa
club. We find ourselves smoking and drinking.
Tunajipata tukivuta sigara.
And by the time God calls you out. It is only by his mercies can you be called out. Do I have any witness in the house? Oh, we bless the Lord. Thank God for the grace. I'm not alone. I am not afraid to talk of my scars, because that is where God brought me from. And I can only say what I have seen, because I have seen God removing me from the pit of hell and putting me on the rock to stand. And I give glory and honor to his name. Shout out to the Lord, a mighty amen. I said, when we came to this world, I want to open a truth to your eyes. Everything that is cornered in this earth, the systems that are operating, it is all about self. That is where selfie came from. It is about me. Self-gratification. Self.
I.
Let me announce to you. In this kingdom, there is no I. There is only God. It is his way or the highway. It is not about how you feel. I am sorry to announce to you, but those women who do strong and great exploits are dead women walking.
Ni wale wenye washakufa ingali wanatembea.
In the book of Revelations
12:12,
Jesus said,
Yesu alisema,
therefore,
basi,
rejoice all ye heavens,
shangilieni nyi bingu,
and you who dwell in them,
na nyinyi ambao mnakaa mbinguni,
woe
basi vi,
to the inhabitants of the earth,
ole wenyu wa
dunia, and the sea. And the sea, for the devil has come down to you having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time. The days of your life shall not go more than 120 days. It is written. It is not me. It is not prophetic. It is written in his word that the days of our lives shall not extend 120. So the problem with humanity is that we think we have time. So when Jesus was saying, because he knows that he has a little but a short time, he knows he has 120 days with you. So he will try to dissuade you. He will try to remove you. He will try to crush you before you get to what God has in store for you. So Jesus said, woe unto the inhabitants, for the enemy is here with you. If you do not live with that recognition, if you do not live in that awareness, the enemy shall take you for a ride. Know that the enemy is here with us. So do not have any doubt. And he comes in every form. He comes in every shape. Your heart has to be waxed strong so that you can be able to withstand the fiery darts of the enemy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, when we came on this earth,
duniani,
I was told, you have to go to school.
Lazima uende shuleni.
Soma na bidii.
Uh-huh.
In fact, my dad,
baba yangu kwanza,
high pastor Cosmas, he was a pastor before.
Yeye alikuwa mchungaji.
He told me,
aliniambia,
you have good brains, wewe.
Wewe uko na akili mingi sana wewe.
Doctor, lawyer.
Uko na wewe daktari.
Kuna zenye nimekupangia.
Uh-huh.
And he saw, and I love my dad.
Nampenda baba yangu
sana. He has the best intentions for me.
Yeye ako na nia mzuri
sana kwangu. So when I came into this earth,
nilipokuja kwa
dunia, we were hardwired
tulikuwa basi
towards a certain way.
Tukaekwa kwa mikakati
towards a certain way of us doing things.
Tukaonyeshwa njia fulani ya kufanya
mambo. But now I want to tell you.
Lakini leo nataka nikwambie.
There is another way.
Kuna njia nyingine.
That is not so spoken about. Thank God for churches.
Ambia haijaongelewa
sana. Thank God for CRE.
Asante Bwana kwa kanisa.
I congratulate our country. Because some of us would have never known about Jesus. It is unfortunate, Mama, that even some parents don't take their children to church. In our own estates, we know
tunajua,
they have no appetite even for the things of God.
Kwa vitu za Mungu.
But there is a generation
kuna
that shall work strong. And imagine when we came,
alipokuja.
Let me go back to my story.
Aha,
I don't want to lose track of it. So we were told to go to school.
Tukambiwa tuende shule.
I went to school.
Nikaenda shule.
School is very important.
Shule ni mzuri sana.
Very important. Because I say, even if God gives you a task, how can you be able to articulate yourself if you don't know how to read? You don't know how to write? You don't know how to balance accounts? So education is very important. But there is another economy. The only economy that can give you favor, even in the marketplace, to be able to be the person that God intends you to be. Do you understand? So there is something very important that God had in store for us, that he had predestined for you, apart from what you see in this world. The Bible says
Biblia inasema
that when you live according to the Spirit,
unapoishi kulingana na
roho, you reap of the Spirit.
Basi
but when you live according to the flesh,
ukiishi kutokana na mwili,
you yield the flesh.
Basi utapata mazao.
Those who are set.
Wale ambao wametengwa.
That's in the book of Romans 8:5.
Kitabu cha Warumi.
It says that
inasema
kuwa those who live according to the flesh,
wale ambao wanaishi kulingana na kimwili,
set their minds,
basi wanauza mambo yao,
on the things of the flesh,
kwa vitu za kimwili,
and those who live according to the Spirit,
wale ambao wanaishi kulingana na
the things of the Spirit,
wanazingatia mambo ya kiroho.
You might ask me, Pastor Queen, what does this mean?
Unaweza niuze inamaanisha nini?
Anytime you invest your life,
wakati wote ambao unaweka
your time,
wakati wako,
your energy,
nguvu zako,
in growing yourself in the things of God,
kwa vitu za Mungu.
Let me give you an example.
Wacha nikupe mfano.
You are employed 8 to 5.
Umeajiriwa.
But you can wake up at 3.
Unaweza amka saa 9
asubuhi. Religiously.
Kidini tu.
And give time to God.
Upe Mungu
in prayer.
Kwa maombi.
In reading the word.
Kusoma neno.
As you're growing in your career, you're also growing in the things of the Spirit.
Pia katika mambo.
So do not grow in one way and separate the other.
No,
what I am telling you is those who live according to the Spirit, those who invest in the things of God, they reap its benefit thereof. But when you live according to the flesh,
oh,
this flesh is wicked. This flesh is wicked because of the sin that was introduced in the garden. So now when you live according to the flesh, you find yourself as a category in the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 21 that it says that, and God gave them over to a debased mind. God gave them over to the appetites of their flesh. If you live according to the flesh, if you refuse to acknowledge God, if you refuse to do the little things, laying the foundation, ABC, read the word of God, stay in prayer, stay true to him, then he gives you over. So Mama, I am not surprised when I see people wearing naked on the streets and they don't care. I see you are a woman or a child of God and you're wearing tight clothes. In fact, tighter than tight.
Aha.
I want to ask you, which God do you represent? There is a way the kingdom of the children of the kingdom of God dress. I am sorry to break your bubble.
Sana,
I am sorry to burst your bubble. Because there has to be a distinction between the children of light and the children of darkness. And we are tired of being lukewarm.
Sasa
we are tired of being lukewarm.
Tumechoka.
They don't like that, Pastor Grace.
Aha, mjafurahia hiyo.
Hey. I told you, see Mimi, don't blame me. Say amen.
Sema amina.
It is well.
Hey.
It is well.
Vyema.
The Lord is patient
Mungu ni
and long suffering. But don't make him suffer for too long.
Usimfanye basi Mungu aumie sana.
It is not rocket science.
Uh-huh.
When you are humble,
wakati wewe ni mnyenyekevu,
before the Spirit of God,
mbele ya roho ya Mungu,
wanasema moyo uliopondeka hutadharau. When you are humble before God,
uwe ni mnyenyekevu mbele ya Mungu,
he starts whispering how his kingdom operates.
Anaanza kukuonyesha jinsi pale
mambo yanafanya. It will have to be seen even on the outside.
Ati itaanza kuonekana
kwa nje. It will be seen from the way you talk.
Itaonekana jinsi unavyoongea.
To the way you dress.
Jinsi unavyovaa.
To the way you operate yourself.
Jinsi ambavyo unafanya mambo yako.
You will find even sometimes when you do something wrong.
Utapata hata wakati
ngine ukikosea. You feel like there's a chastisement.
Unahisi tu kuna kitu.
You feel like the Holy Spirit has said, ah.
Unasikia tu Roho Mtakatifu.
There's something wrong you have done.
Umekosea mahali wewe.
But if you don't feel that thing.
Lakini kama uhisi hivyo.
If there is no chastisement on your soul, I want to ask you by the mercies of God. Today go and ask God. Purge me again. In roho hii. Ifunje funje.
Aha.
Ikate kate.
Aha.
So that there is nothing in me.
Ili hakuna chochote
ndani yangu. That is arising itself against you.
Unajinua zaidi yako.
So if you find yourself among this category.
Ukijipata kwa hiki kundi ya watu.
Haters of God.
Ah, wale ambao wanamchukia Mungu.
Whisperers.
Wale ambao wananungunika.
Wanawake, you know, I like talking the truth.
Napenda kusema ukweli.
Women, God help us.
Wanawake, Mungu atusaidie sana.
Let me tell you.
Wacha niwaambie.
Let me tell you.
Wacha niwaambie.
I know the women from this ministry.
Najua wanawake wa hii huduma.
And the women from ministry, the ministry I serve. We shall be women that shall be clear cut.
Tutakuwa wanawake
when you are gossiping. We'll be talking like this.
Tunaposengenya.
Oh, by the way, Acts chapter 9, it's a hot scripture. My God, may God help us to live like the Deborah woman, the Proverbs 31 woman. But you're not sitting down to say, uliona huyo mtu vile amevaa. That is child talk.
Hiyo ni utoko.
We are done with that.
Tumetoka huko.
Are you done with me?
Je, umeachana
na hiyo? Are you done with me?
Umemalizana na hiyo?
We will love God.
Tutampenda Mungu.
Because those that love him.
Wale ambao wanampenda Mungu.
They do these things not.
Wanafanya haya mambo.
They are not unforgiving.
Basi wao huwa wanasamehe.
They are not proud.
Wao si wenye kiburi.
They are not uncaring.
Wao huwa wanajali watu.
You know,
najua.
It is unfortunate what I see out there.
Kile ambacho ninaona
kile. Sometimes you go even to just to get normal service.
Uenda tu basi kupata huduma.
Mwenye anakuserve na anasema hata ameweka wimbo ya Mungu hapo. Bwana ni mchungaji wangu. Sasa yeye anakuangalia hivi. I'm like, God.
Ah, Mungu wetu.
What is the problem?
Ni nini inaendelea?
It is because God has, it's like lip service. You remember what Jesus said the Gentiles do? Because the inside of your cup, it is dirty. But you wash the outside.
Lakini unaosha
nje. In the outside you look arranged.
Nje unakaa
sawa. You look like a mighty woman of valor. You look like you got it all together. But inside, you are rotten.
Wewe umeoza. Ha.
Only those
watu wale tu
who wake up at 3
ambao wanaamka saa 9
when no one is watching them,
ambapo hakuna mtu
anaona, who wake up in the middle of the night when Pastor Grace is not watching you and you're there just crying to God and saying, God, what are you saying about my generation? God, what are you saying about my children? God, what are you saying about our church? God, what are you saying about our pastors? Oh, those women are the women who God shall raise and the women who God shall give purpose.
Ambao Mungu atawapea nia.
If you are at your prayer altar,
kama wewe uko kwa
mahali pa Mungu
kila wakati,
and you sit and kneel to God,
na unampigia Mungu
at the feet of Jesus every day, and you come out and live the same,
na unatoka pale,
your wardrobe is still the same.
Basi kila
kitu what you used to wear, tight, skimpy and
bado unavaa vitu za kukubana na vitu vifupi.
That is what you're still wearing today.
Hiyo bado unavaa hata leo.
May your fire be the real fire.
Acha basi moto yako
ikuwe. May your fire be the real fire.
Moto yako ikuwe moto ya kweli.
That can find expression even in your heart.
Ile ambayo inaweza onekana mpaka kwa
moyo wako. That can make you change what you listen to.
Ambayo inaweza kufanya tu badilisha
wimbo wako. That can make you change your friends.
Ile ambayo inaweza fanya
badilisha marafiki. That can make you change your wardrobe.
Badilisha hata mavazi yako.
That can make you even change the way you dress.
Ubadilisha hata jinsi unavyovaa.
I almost said something.
Karibu niseme tu kitu.
But I said I'll not say.
Ah, nikasema sitasema hivyo.
Not today.
Si leo.
Today I have done it enough.
Leo nimesema ya kutosha.
Another day.
Siku nyingine.
I will come.
Ndakuja tena.
Mama giving me a chance.
Nikipewa ruhusa na mama yetu.
In the book of John chapter 6 verse 44.
Kitabu cha Yohana mlango wa 6 mlango
wa It says.
Inasema.
No one can come to me.
Hakuna yote ambaye atanijia mimi.
John 6 chapter 44.
Kitabu cha Yohana mlango wa 6.
No one can come to me.
Hakuna yote ambaye anaweza nijia.
Unless the Father who sent me.
Ila tu baba ambaye alinituma.
Draws him.
Amtume.
And I will raise him up in the last day.
Na mimi nitamfufua siku ya mwisho.
This is what I was telling you in the beginning. Because we are incapable of drawing ourselves to God. I am here to announce to you, child of God, you being here in this conference, in this prayer meeting, it is only by the mercies of God. And it is not only that, it is because He has drawn you. No one can come to Him unless He draws you. So sometimes I want to pray more for the people I see in sin than to start talking about them. Because I have come to realize that my sister, who has not been drawn to God, unless God draws her, she cannot be drawn. So for you who have been drawn, do not be a judge over the others who have not been drawn. If you try to be a judge, that means you are thumping your chest and saying that, God, I did it for myself. So when we approach God, we approach Him with a humility to understand that it's only by His grace that we have been drawn in. Just say, God, thank you. Thank you for drawing me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So this is the foundations I'm laying. So when God draws you, that's where you said, I am saved. And now salvation is the beginning of a whole journey of life until you are glorified to God. So when you began the work of salvation, you started a period of purification and sanctification. Because remember, you were in the world, but now you have been drawn to Christ. So you came to Him like a baby with a lot of chafu. Wewe ulikuwa mchafu. Ulikuja kwake ukiwa mchafu sana. So when He came, He took you in. Now He's starting to wash you. So don't think that salvation will happen, bam, and then you're changed, bam. But only if you are submissive and allow the Spirit of God to mold you, can you become a vessel of honor. So salvation, as I've said, it is a journey of being made sanctified
for kutakaswa.
Awesome.
Yes.
So it says in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 10, I want to show you what happened at salvation. With your mouth you confessed unto salvation, and with your heart you believed unto righteousness. I want to show you, child of God, how believing is so important. Believing that you are a woman of worth. Believing that you are a child of God. It is so important. Let me show you why. Do you know the day you got born again? Most probably for
me,
there was no fireworks. No, I didn't see it. But it was something inside of me that changed. I believed that my prayer and my salvation is real. So that is the basis of your salvation. And it is tied together with faith. What is faith? Scholars in the house.
Wasomi.
I know Mama knows. Mama has saved you. Very good. Very good. Clap for Mama because she knows how to save her children. Very good. Faith is a substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not yet. So when you got born again, why did you get born again? Through faith. Why?
Kwa nini?
What was your expectation? Did you ever ask yourself, why am I doing this? It is to glorify God and for you to be able to be separated from the fiber of this world so that you can be fit for the kingdom that you do not see. So how do we attain this? We walk by faith and not by sight. When God tells you something in the middle of the night,
kuambia kitu usiku.
You do it.
Fanya vile.
Stop asking God questions like Moses.
Maswali.
Moses told God all the things he was not.
Kila kitu.
He said everything he was not.
Alijua kila kitu ambaye
hakuwa. But God says something to you.
Lakini Mungu akamwambia.
Do it.
Fanya.
God says.
Mungu akisema.
Okay, I'll say it. I don't know why he's telling me to say this.
Daisema.
He says, so.
Akisema basi to mbegu.
So into the ministry.
Panda mbegu kwa kanisa.
It is my work.
Ni kazi yangu.
But you hold back.
Lakini wewe unakataa.
Because you are used to hearing
kwa sababu umezoea
that you are going to be blessed.
Kwamba utabarikiwa.
God will give you a car.
Mungu atakupea gari.
Beloved children of God.
Aha.
I am here to tell you by the mercies of God.
Nakwambia kwa huruma za Mungu.
I have seen a truth that nobody told me.
Hakuna mtu aliniambia.
I give because it is God who has asked me to give.
Napeana kwa sababu ni Mungu ame.
Because it is his kingdom.
Kwa sababu ni falme wake.
I give because his work has to continue.
Kazi yake lazima iendelee.
I give because I have nothing that he did not give me.
Hakuna chochote ambaye niko naye ambayo ni yangu.
There is nothing.
Hakuna chochote.
That I cannot give God.
Ambayo siwezi mpea
Mungu. He has asked us for everything.
Hakuna chochote.
And we gave everything.
Na tunapeana
kila kitu. We were left with nothing.
Tukabaki
bure. And God started us again.
Mungu akatuanzisha
tena. So child of God.
Basi mwana wa Mungu.
In the middle of the night.
Katika usiku.
When God is telling you kingdom matters.
Mungu akikwambia
mambo ya kingdom.
Wacha kumshuku.
Stop doubting God.
Wacha kumshuku.
Stop doubting God.
Wacha kumshuku Mungu.
He walks by faith.
Anatembea utembea kwa
imani. He does not walk by sight.
Atembea kwa kuona.
And you cannot understand this God.
Uenda usielewe.
Hey, sometimes he asks you to do things.
Wakati mwingine anakuuliza
kwa nini. And then God, how does this add up?
Unamuuliza hii itakuwa.
Where is this adding in my life?
Mungu. Ah.
But when you walk in obedience.
Unapotembea kwa kutii.
Because faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Basi imani ni kitu ambacho
unatarajia. So he knows what is waiting for you.
Kile ambacho unahitaji.
So he tells you, because I love you, you love me.
Kwa sababu unanipenda na
kupenda. You claim you love me.
Unadai unanipenda.
Close your eyes.
Funga macho.
And let me lead.
Na wacha basi nikuongoze.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wow, I like I'm doing good. I'm going with my notes. Hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So if God tells you to do something,
Mungu akikwambia ufanye chochote,
please do it.
Tafadhali fanya hivyo.
Whatever it is.
Ikuwe ni nini?
Spend your life.
Basi tumia hata maisha yako.
Spend your life.
Jimwage kikamilifu.
Spend your life, child of God.
Jimwage kabisa.
Have nothing you have left inside.
Usibakishe chochote ndani yako.
Let him be the center of your heart.
Wacha baki basi yeye ndiye
wako kwa moyo wako. I say this with all humility.
Nasema kwa unyenyekevu.
I even preach this in my church.
Hata nilihubiri kwa kanisa.
I'm sorry, I'll introduce the ones I came with.
Ndawa.
When we are done.
Tukimaliza ndawajilisha.
I say.
Nikasema.
I tell them.
Nikawaambia.
In this heart of mine.
Kwa hii moyo wangu.
I came to realize.
Nilikuja kugundua.
That there should be no one.
Kinafaa kusikwe na
no one.
Hakusikwe na chochote.
Who I glorify more than God.
Ambaye anatukuzwa kuliko Mungu.
Women.
Wanawake sikia.
Please listen to me.
Sikizeni wanawake.
Do not glorify anything.
Usiwahi tukuza chochote.
More than God.
Zaidi ya Mungu.
That is why you stay with a man.
Ndio maana unakaa
na mtu. Who keeps beating you.
Ambaye anakupiga.
Beating you like pulp.
Anakupiga.
Left, right and center.
Hey, hey.
Don't you realize your worth.
Ujui.
Don't you know who's you are.
Ujui wewe ni wanani.
Because you have put someone else.
Umeweka mtu mwingine kwa moyo wako.
At the center of your heart.
Hapo katikati ya moyo wako.
Who comes and spoils the image of God?
Ambaye anakuja na haribu sura ya Mungu.
Who comes and patters the image of God?
Ambaye anakuja na haribu sura ya Mungu.
And he comes and buys you drugs and alcohol.
Anakubaiya pombe.
For you to be a woman who is worthless.
Ili kuwe basi hauna dhamana tena.
Because you have not known.
Kwa sababu wewe hujajua.
Who should be the center of your heart?
Anafaa kuwa
moyo wako. You are allowing every Tom, Dick and Harry.
Utawachilia tu kila kitu.
To come and spoil your destiny.
Ikuje tu haribu maisha yako.
To come and I want to say I'm not going to say it. I was going to say something radical.
Karibu niseme kitu
hapa. But I'm not going to say it.
Ah, sitaisema.
I know you know what I mean.
Najua mnajua kile namaanisha. Wanawake.
It is time for you.
Imefika sasa.
To realize who you are.
Kugundua wewe ni nani ndani ya Mungu.
Who you are in Christ Jesus.
Wewe ni nani nani ndani ya Kristo.
No one. I came to announce no one can give you identity.
Hakuna yote ambaye anaweza kukupa.
Except Elohim.
Isipokuwa tu Yesu.
No one can tell you this is what I wrote about your life.
Hakuna mtu anajua maisha yako.
Unless Elohim does it.
Ni Yesu tu anajua.
And if you align yourself.
Ukiamua kukubali.
To women of God.
Aha.
Who can point you towards the direction. Who can point you towards the truth. And that's why you have a mama. Who loves God. Who is dedicated to God. She says this is the way. Walk in it.
Walk. Walk.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we are at the place where now we have gone to school. Our careers are good. Everything is working good for us. But then again, there is an economy that keeps creeping up. You see, with the things of God, He starts shaping your heart. There is a way your heart looks when you come to Him. But He starts shaping your heart. Hapo ndio kazi iko. Na hapo ndio tunakuanga na resistance. Unaanza kuambia Mungu mimi sitaki. Unaanza kuambia Mungu mimi siwezi change. Unaanza kuambia Mungu hapana. Mungu anakuambia tuombe tu. I love what mama does.
Yes.
Mama is praying here. I know you pray for many hours.
Yeah.
I see you on Facebook. And I want to tell you, it is not in vain. Continue to pressure and continue to press in. Continue to stay in the vineyard. Because the time shall come when you shall go to draw from the bank deposit. And if your deposit has been
deemed,
you cannot withdraw. That's why I say to my people, do not be surprised when others come and they get blessings more than you. Because they have been doing deposit and they meant it. The time shall come.
Wakati utafika.
When it shall be time for you.
Itakuwa ni wakati wako.
To go and plead the case of your grandchildren.
Uenda basi kuchukua
to plead the case of your generations.
Kesi ya vizazi vyako.
And you shall go and to God and say.
Na utaenda kwa Mungu na
umwambie. God, do you remember me?
Hey, Mungu unanikumbuka.
I have a story of a wonderful friend of mine.
Niko na hadithi ya rafiki yangu moja.
She told me this story of her mom.
Aliniambia hii hadithi kuhusu mama yake.
She's late. God rest her soul.
Mama yake alishakufa.
This woman,
huyu mwanamke,
used she was abandoned by her husband.
Aliachwa na mumeo.
With 9 children.
Na watoto wa 9.
In the middle of, thank you. In the middle of ukamba landuko, the mashinani. Mali kuko yani uko matope ni there is no land, no vegetation, I mean.
Hakuna chochote ambayo ni kijani kibichi.
It was all red.
Ilikuwa ni nyekundu umekauka.
But this woman,
lakini huyu mwanamke,
she used to hold keshas by herself.
Alikuwa anajiwekea kesha mwenyewe.
Praying.
Akiomba tu.
Praying for her children.
Akiombea watoto wake.
At that moment,
kwa hiyo wakati basi,
everybody was laughing at her.
Alikuwa anamcheka.
Maybe they saw there is nothing she's
waliona
doing.
Waliona ni kama anafanya
bure. And she did it in silence.
Aliendelea tu kufanya
kwa upole. It is only her daughter who knew, who was my prayer partner.
Ni yule tu mtoto wake alikuwa
anajua. So she shared with me.
Akaniambia basi.
But let me tell you a truth.
Wacha niwaambie ukweli.
That I have observed with all those 9 children.
Nimeona kwa hao watoto wake wote.
Now they are all grown up like me and married.
Sasa wote ni watu wazima na maolewa.
All of them serve God.
Wote wanamtumikia Mungu.
All of them, not
wote,
even one.
Wote hakuna hata mmoja ambaye hamtumikii.
None of her children.
Hakuna watoto wake wote.
Went to the ways of the world.
Ambao waliingia kwa njia za kidunia.
So I want to ask you.
Nataka nikuulize nawe.
Don't you understand?
Je, huelewi?
The purpose of prayer.
Ni ile umuhimu wa maombi.
Don't you understand the purpose of being consistent?
Je, hujelewa ile kuomba kwa kuendelea?
Not only prayer but consistency.
Kuendelea maombi sio mara moja tu na acha. Kuendelea kuomba.
And also having a heart.
Na kuwa na ile moyo
that it has been imekunjwa.
Aha.
Mungu anaikunja day and night. Because we shall know them by their fruits.
Tutawajua kwa matunda yao.
You can be saying Lord, Lord.
Unaweza kusema
Bwana, Bwana. But when I look at your actions,
ninapoangalia matendo yako,
they do not portray
azionekani
this which is written in the word.
Kile ambacho kimeandikwa.
So that is a difference between the children of light.
Basi ni tofauti katika wale wana wa
mwanga. The children of darkness.
Na wale wana wa giza.
And do not be fooled.
Usidanganyike basi.
We are coming to a dispensation.
Tumekuja kwa nyakati sasa.
Where we shall not be children who shall be given to the things of this world.
Basi hatutapeanwa kwa vitu za
kidunia. We are not women.
Sisi sio wana
who are given to the looks of this world.
Ambao tunataka tu kuonekana.
We are not interested. With wealth.
Atu singa
we are not going to add anything.
Hatutakuwa na chochote.
Here or there.
Hapa au mapale.
We will not add.
Hatutaongeza chochote.
Anything to be loved.
Chochote ambayo kitawa.
Or to be liked.
Ile ambayo kitataka.
Because you want to satisfy the appetite of a man.
Ili uweze tu kufurahisha
binadamu. So now you go and start changing your ways.
Unaanza basi
kubadilisha. To change the way God created you.
Weka jinsi Mungu alikuumba.
To change the way God made you.
Weka jinsi
Mungu alikuumba. Because you're telling God, this
one
cannot satisfy the man you gave me.
Hazitoshelezi mwanamume
uliye nipa. That means you're with the wrong one.
Inamaanisha wewe hauko pale inafaa.
Sisi ndio.
Haha.
Women,
wanawake nisikizeni.
who have been made by God. Who have been formatted by God. So they come into the stage in your estates, in your organizations everywhere. They pop up and then you say,
"Our
ni washamba." No, we represent the kingdom of
God.
We are not washamba. Forget it. Honestly, do we look like washambas? Children of God, women of God, they are intellects.
Tumesoma.
And even if you just soma, in the spirit, you're a warrior.
Wewe ni
you can pray tongues that have never been heard before. You can lift up the banner of praise like no one before.
Kwa Mungu.
So give praise unto the Lord for his good. Shout unto the Lord.
Wokozi wake, tushangilie Bwana.
Matthew 23:25. For those who clean the outside of the cup, but the inside is dirty. I talked about this some time back. You see, I went even ahead of myself. But this ties in.
Lakini hii wakati,
this ties in
hii wakati,
with those that have allowed the Spirit of God
wale ambao basi
wameruhusu to mold them and make them
awaunde na awaunde
into vessels of honor.
Ili wakwe basi vyombo
I charge shi. You by the mercies of God.
Inakwambia tuko huruma za Mwenyezi.
After today when we have met like this,
baada ya leo hii tukiachana hapa,
may you start a journey.
Anza basi safari
of being molded
ya kuundwa
to be a vessel that God intended you to be.
Ili uwe chombo ambacho Mungu alitamania uwe hapo
mwanzo. It is not enough to speak.
Ijatosha tu kuongea.
It is not enough to talk.
Ijatosha tu kunena.
But let me see you by your fruit.
Wacha ni kuone kwa mazao yako.
Let me be able to see and see that the Lord has been working something inside of you.
Wacha nione kwamba kuna
utenda kazi ndani yako. So that it is seen on the outside. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For the interest of time, let's go to the book of John chapter 4 verse 23.
Kitabu cha Yohana mlango wa 4 mstari wa
23. John chapter 4 verse 23 to 24 that says,
nasema,
but the hour is coming.
Basi muda unafika.
And now is
sasa ndipo
when the true worshipers
basi wale ambao wanamwabudu Mungu kweli
shall worship the Lord
basi watamwabudu Mungu
in spirit
katika roho
and in truth
na kweli.
For the Father
kwa sababu Baba
is seeking
anamtafuta
such
kama wale
to worship him
ili wamwabudu yeye.
Serve God
basi mtumikie Mungu
how he wants to be served
jinsi ambavyo yeye anataka kutumikiwa.
Represent God
mwakilishe Mungu
the way he wants to be represented
jinsi yeye anataka awakilishwe.
Love God
pende Mungu
the way he wants to be loved
jinsi yeye anataka apendwe.
Let your hands be clean.
Wacha mikono yako na ibaki iwe safi.
There's a scripture that's coming to my mind that says
kuna neno inanijia
who shall
nani
who
basi
shall ascend at the mountain of the Lord.
Nani basi atainukia juu katika
mlima wa Bwana.
Ni yule tu
clean hands
ambaye ako na mikono safi
and a pure heart.
Na moyo safi.
The Lord is seeking.
Bwana anawatafuta
kabisa. Those who have cleaned the inside.
Wale ambao wamesafisha ndani yao.
Of their cup.
Ehe ndani ya vikombe vyao.
So that from the inside.
Ili kutokana kule ndani.
It comes on the outside.
Itatoka mpaka huku nje.
Walk in total submission.
Tembea kwa unyenyekevu ya hali ya juu.
And humility.
Na unyenyekevu.
Humility is one of the things I've seen.
Unyenyekevu ni kitu moja ambacho nimeona ambayo Mungu
that touches his heart.
Inamgusa moyo wa Mungu.
That's why David.
Ndio maana Daudi
was termed a man after God's heart.
Alisema kwamba yeye ni mtu ambaye Mungu alimpenda.
He knew how to tune God.
Alijua jinsi ya ku
He knew how to be humble.
Jinsi ya kunyenyekea.
Do not raise yourself above others.
Usijinue juu zaidi ya wengine.
Be a servant at all times.
Wewe kuwa mtu wa kuhudumu
siku zote. If God has raised you,
Mungu kama amekuinua,
to be any level of leadership.
Kwa kiwango chochote cha uongozi.
Show God.
Onyesha Mungu basi.
Through your leadership.
Kupitia uongozi wako.
Express God.
Basi onyesha Mungu.
Through your leadership.
Kupitia uongozi wako.
Personalize your work.
Basi weka kazi
yako. To portray the kingdom of God.
Ili onyeshe ufalme wa Kristo.
Ask God.
Uliza Mungu.
In my workplace.
Kwa kila mahali yangu
kazi. How can I represent you?
Naweza basi kukuwakilisha
vipi? How can I bring you around in my work?
Naweza kuleta aje pale pangu pa kazi.
I love a company that has invited me to go minister on Monday.
Napenda kampuni ambayo imenialika niende
tu. It's a big company.
Ni kampuni kubwa.
But it shocked me.
Lakini ilinishangaza.
That they have services every month.
Wako na ibada kila mwezi.
Every Monday.
Kila Jumatatu.
They invite a speaker.
Wao watamwalika basi.
Then they have Thanksgiving service I think every few months.
Aha, watakuwa na maibada ya kushukrani.
In companies
kwa makampuni
that are owned by what was this Hindus.
Ambayo basi inamilikiwa na Wahindi.
Tell me.
Ah, niambie.
What is that woman saying?
Je, huyo mwanamke anasema
nini? That even if I am working for this,
hata ingawa mimi ninafanyia Wahindi kazi,
I am going.
Mimi naenda pale.
To introduce a system.
Basi kuleta mikakati.
To introduce the God of heaven.
Kuleta basi Mungu wa mbinguni.
Into this system.
Kwa hii mikakati.
Because she is a woman who has understood.
Kwa sababu yeye ni mwanamke ambaye ameelewa.
In the workplace.
Kazi yake na huyo
mwanamke. Child of God, do not be afraid.
Wanangu,
because the Bible says
that
he has not given us a spirit of fear.
Hajatupea roho ya woga.
Boldness and of a sound mind. I am not telling you to go and defy all odds. God shall give you favor. God shall give you wisdom. God shall give you direction on how to inject his precepts and his laws into that organization. Clap unto the Lord. Ask him for that wisdom in Jesus' name. Mama, I want to conclude this matter.
Wacha nimalize hili jambo.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 13 says.
Sio kitabu cha Mhubiri.
Ecclesiastes 12:13.
Mlango wa 12.
Let us hear.
Tusikize basi.
The conclusion of this matter. Children of God.
Watoto wana wa Mungu.
We were created.
Tuliumbwa.
To fear God.
Ili tum ogope Mungu.
And keep his commandments.
Na tuweke basi amri zake.
It is as simple as that.
Ni rahisi tu hivyo.
And as complicated as that.
Na pia ni vigumu tu hivyo.
Fear God.
Muogope Mungu.
When you fear God, you shall not fear anything else.
Unapomwogopa Mungu hutaogopa chochote tena.
Some of you are afraid.
Wengine wenu mnaogopa.
When someone said something about you.
Wakisema kitu juu yako.
And you felt that you cannot do it.
Unahisi kwamba huwezi
fanya. And God told you to do that.
Na Mungu alikwambia fanya hivyo.
But you're telling God I cannot do it.
Lakini unamwambia Mungu siwezi.
And I want to ask you.
Acha nikuulize.
Who is it that you fear?
Je, unamwogopa nani?
He is the creator of the universe.
Yeye ndiye muumbaji wa dunia mzima.
He's the one who caused Pharaoh.
Yeye ndio basi alifanya
Farao. His heart to be waxed cold.
Moyo wake uwe baridi hata.
He can cause things to change around for you.
Anaweza fanya hata wewe mambo ya kubadilisha.
He can cause the hearts of men to favor you.
Anaweza fanya basi moyo wao.
People who have never looked at you with favor.
Watu ambao hawajai kupa kibali.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Katika jina la Yesu Kristo.
They shall look at you with favor.
Na kupe kibali.
Total reverence.
Aha.
And respect.
Umuogopa Mungu.
To the name of God.
Kwa jina la Mungu.
I wrote here.
Niliandika hapa.
Mama. Mhm. We should stop lip service.
Tuache tu kunena tu kwa mdomo.
Why it is in the mouth?
Iko tu kwa mdomo yako.
But it is not in your heart.
Kwa moyo wako haiko hata.
Leviticus 6 verse 12 as I close. And the fire on the altar.
Na basi moto ulio madhabahuni
shall be kept burning.
Utatunzwa uwake.
And it shall not be put out.
Usizimike.
Women of God.
Sikieni basi wanawake wa Mungu.
Your prayer life.
Maisha yako ya maombi.
Your love for God.
Ile upendo wako kwa Mungu.
It should never burn. It should never burn out.
Isizimika.
It doesn't matter what happens.
Haijalishi nini inaendelea.
I want you to put in your head.
Nataka uweke hii kwa akili yako.
It doesn't matter.
Haijalishi.
What happens.
Ni nini kinaendelea.
I was talking about it the other day.
Nilikuwa niongelelea hata siku
nyingine. In the book of Psalms chapter 85.
Kitabu cha Zaburi.
It says that.
Inasema kuwa.
If I'm not wrong, it says that those that acknowledge the Lord.
Wale ambao basi wanamkiri Mungu.
They set their heart on pilgrimage.
Wanaweka basi moyo wao.
And as they pass through the valley of Baca.
Wanapopitia basi katika mabonde ya Baca.
They make it a place of spring.
Inakuwa ni basi mahala pa Baca.
You know where Baca is.
Najua pale ambapo Baca.
Baca was a valley.
Baca ilikuwa ni bonde.
That used to have many pools.
Ilikuwa basi na vizima mingi.
And when the rain came.
Wakati mvua ilinyesha.
The pools were so many.
Zile vizima zilikuwa mingi.
They had to drain out the water.
Ilibidi watoe ile maji.
For them to cross.
Ili wavuke.
And the Lord was telling me.
Na Mungu alikuwa ananiambia.
Tell my women.
Ambia wanawake wangu.
That these are the pools they face.
Basi hizi ni visima ambavyo watapatana nako maisha.
Pools of shame.
Basi aibu.
Pools of regret.
Ah, na
pools of disappointment.
Kukwazika.
Oh, some of us have lost children.
Wengine wetu tumepoteza
watoto. Some of us have lost relationships.
Tumepoteza mahusiano.
Some of us have been shamed.
Tumeaibika.
Some of us have been disgraced. blessed. But the Lord said that those who set their heart on me, those who have me at the center of their heart, oh, I shall be their Lord and I shall be their God. And it says that if you walk in this way and if you are keeping the fire burning and if you are submitted to God and if you are a woman who doesn't, it doesn't matter, even if you are in the lowest of low of low of low, we are women who have even one day not even have 100 bob for fair, and we never went to sell ourselves on the streets because we are not merchandise. We just said God in heaven, if you don't come through for me, then who will? And imagine out of that situation, God is looking at you in that pool and looking at you in that valley and saying, my daughter, are you going to give in? My daughter, are you going to give in? If you stay faithful, if you keep the fire burning, he shall establish you forever and ever. Amen. So when you do this, all these things that I've said, then you shall be a vessel that shall be able to go back to Daniel 11:32 and say, those that know the Lord their God shall do great, shall be strong and do great and mighty exploits. If you stay with these things, if you stay with God long enough to keep the fire burning, long enough to keep the fire burning, then you shall work strong, then you shall do exploits, then the Lord shall use you to do great and mighty things. Oh, be on your feet, even as we give a clap unto the Lord. Oh, Rebecca, oh, we bless you, Jesus. I pray among this meeting, oh God, that you're going to raise women who are going to do great and mighty exploits. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, oh God, for the ability to be able to work strong.